describe it like I would describe him as a person, very energetic, just a lot of kicking, obviously, as a kickboxer, but his kicks are amazing. He's got a really good stance and strength on his shoulders, so he's a great fighter.
Michael Carson is, he's the king. He's the king of kickboxing. And he's also from Rochester. Uber a lot on the weekends right after I get out of my work shifts. So like I might Uber really after my practices. So say like it's a Monday night. Well maybe this is like it's like a Monday night and I have time. I might Uber for like 1 to 2 hours once I get out of kickboxing practice. My girlfriend, she's been there every step of the way since I've started. Like if I hadn't met her, I probably would have never been kickboxing ever in my life. Or not even have had like the confidence to do it, to be completely honest with you. Like, she's such a blessing. She was encouraged, she was very encouraging every step of the way. Like, I never felt any doubt in her heart or her mind that she never believed in me, what I could do or what I would tell her I could do, you know?
I've been in business for 20 years, and we've had accomplished fighters from myself to Tom Vanderhorst, people, pros. We've had never had anyone like stays after class and mops the mats consistently like Mike does, or help out the new guys. You see somebody stuttering, he's helping out these guys. This guy's got a title fight coming up. So it's just, not only does he work hard for his own goals, he makes sure that every other boat is rising up in their dock as well.
And how would you describe him as a fighter?
Oh my God, he's a man. He's up and coming. He's the closest word I can, or the best word I can use. He's an up and coming guy right now. He's flashy. He sticks to his game plan. He listens. Can't ask for much more from a fighter, honestly.
And do you ever get scared watching him fight?
Oh yeah, all the time. I mean, I don't get too afraid now because of his record. Now he's 12-0.